Hey guys! Cats are my favorite animals. They are so cute, silly, and fluffy. And today's project is inspired by Crafted. That's why I will show you how to create a cute DIY gift set that includes 5 different cat-inspired things. This set is a perfect gift for a cat lady or a gentleman in your life, or just for yourself. It's easy and fun to create, so let's get started. To create a top and a bag with a cat print, you will need an uncooked potato, a cutter, fabric paint in the color of your choice, a cotton tote bag, and a top. Start off by cutting the potato in half. Then, with a marker or pen, draw the shape of a cat's head. Then, with the cutter, start cutting the shape along the guideline. If you have that, cut a little bit into the potato and start cutting along the edges. I cut in about 5 mm or so. This way, we can remove the excess potato. Just carefully cut out everything that is outside the shape you drew on to create a stamp. Then take a folder or thick paper and place it into the tote bag to avoid the paint staining the other side of the bag. If you have that, you can go ahead and apply the fabric paint onto the potato and carefully place it onto the fabric. I used a brush to apply the paint, this way I could apply the right amount of paint without wasting it. Just carefully place the potato onto the fabric and press it down, and then slowly remove it. If you notice anything about the stamp that you don't like, you can just remove it with a cutter. Repeat this process until you are happy with the design. For the gray shirt, I used white fabric paint. I kinda like that the color was not so well covering. This way, the stamp created a unique cat design. And if you get any paint somewhere else, you can quickly remove it with a Q-tip. I also added some whiskers and a nose to some of the cat patterns. I think this makes the design even cuter. And if you would like to create a paw pattern, cut the potato in half but along the thin side. Then draw a heart the wrong way around. And then 4 small circles around the top area. If you have that, go ahead and cut out the shape the same way as we did with the cat's head. With this stamp, I kinda created a tail on the back of the shirt. But you can also print the whole shirt with this pattern as well. Then I quickly went ahead and added some more details to the tote bag before I let everything dry. When everything was dry, I placed a cloth on top of the fabric and paint and ironed it for a few minutes to make it machine washable. And you are done! This top and bag were so easy to create and I love how they turned out. To create a cute cat mug, you will need a white mug, porcelain paint or pens, and rubbing alcohol. First, clean the outside of your mug with some rubbing alcohol to remove any oil. Then draw a heart for the nose, the mouth, and the whiskers right around the edge of the mug. Be sure to draw the design on the opposite side of the mug when you hold it in your hand. If you want, you can add more details to the mug. I added a few cat paws and some cute cat arms. Then let it dry and bake it. And again, be sure to read the instructions of your pens or paint first. And to create these 3D cat paw socks, I used a 3D liner in pink. And you will also need socks. First, put some cardboard inside the socks, but be sure that the heel of the sock is facing the ceiling. If you have that, go ahead and line out the heart the other way around and add 4 small circles around the top area as we did with the paw stamp in the beginning. Then just paint everything in and let it dry. To fix this paint and to make it machine washable, you have to either iron it or bake it. After that, the paint got all puffy. And you are done! This 3D liner is great if you want to create 3D paws and make the socks slip resistant as well. And if you would like to create the sleeping mask, you will need light gray, dark gray, pink and white felt fleece or fabric, scissors, white embroidery floss, needles for the floss, an elastic band, and fabric glue if you don't want to sew. First, cut out the template I made for you. Then, place it on top of the light gray fleece or felt and secure it with some needles. Then cut out the shape, you will need 2 of them, for the front and back side. Then cut out the heart shape using the template. To make sure that the nose is at the same place as on the template, I place a template onto the shape and pierce both the needle right where the nose and mouth meet each other. If you have that, you can go ahead and glue on the nose with some fabric glue. Cut off some white floss, thread a needle and make a few knots at one of the ends. Since we already have attached the nose, it will help us to stitch the cat's mouth. I use a simple running stitch method. I passed the needle in and then when I wanted to pass the needle out, I went through the stitch I just created. Then I repeated the step. You can decide what length you would like the stitches to be. When I created one side of the mouth, I pulled the needle through one of the stitches on the back side to create a loop. And then I pulled the floss through this loop twice to secure the stitch. Cut off the excess thread and repeat the step on the other side. If you have that, you can start stitching the whiskers. And do the same for the eyes. Since I used felt, I could pierce through the needle along the template. This way the needle created a guideline for me. Then I went ahead and glued on the pattern above the eyes. But I wouldn't recommend gluing on the ears just yet, as it might not look cute in the end. Now we need to prepare the band so the mask can actually be worn. For this step, wrap the elastic band around your head where you would wear the mask, but don't pull on the band. Mark the length with a needle or pen so you know the length. And then take the mask and place it onto the band right next to the marked point and cut off the length of the mask. Now we need to glue the two pieces together. For this step, add the fabric glue to the backside pattern along the edges, but be sure to leave out the areas on the left and right side where the band will be later. Place the pattern with the face onto the glue, but be sure that the face is facing towards the desk, as we will turn everything inside out. Press everything together and let it dry. When the glue has dried, go ahead and turn the mask inside out to make it the right way around. You can use a pen or scissors to help you out. I decided to add some filling so my mask is not too flat, but this is optional as well. Now all we need to do is adding the elastic band. For this step, add some fabric glue to the openings and add the elastic band inside at about 1 cm or so. Firmly press the pieces together so everything can glue together very well. Repeat the same on the other side without twisting the elastic band. Now you can go ahead and glue on any areas that you might have missed and let everything dry. And you are done! Now you can put everything inside a tote bag and you get a cute gift set for you or your friend. Thank you guys for watching. I also want to thank Hills Pet Crafted for helping me create this cat-inspired DIY. When I learned about their food, I found that we actually have a lot of things in common. For example, they asked me about my artistic passion and why I like to craft. And one of my passions during the process of making videos for you guys is that I always pay attention to every detail. Because I believe that this way I can create the best content and the best quality that you guys deserve. And what I like about his new product line called Crafted is that they use thoughtfully sourced ingredients that are high quality. Because you also believe that it's important to pay attention to details if you want to create good quality food so you can take good care of your furry friends. And if you would like to learn more about Crafted and what small batch actually means to them, check out my description box for more information. I really hope you enjoyed this DIY gift set and found it helpful. Like this video if you did and subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss any of my fun and easy DIYs in the future. Have a wonderful day everyone and see you next week.